All right. Good afternoon or good morning, everyone. My name is Eugenia, and here is my Magnificent by Design series. And today I have Karissa, Karissa Pezzillo with me. Karissa is a psychic who works the channel and helps people find their kind of, shares messages from the spirit and helps people through the spirit to understand their direction in life or to answer any questions that they might have. And of course, I'll let Karissa speak a little bit more about what she does and why and how. And I have actually myself worked with Karissa, and I think that she's absolutely amazing. Mm-hmm. Karissa, welcome. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me on here and for the work that you do as well. You've helped me so much on my path too, to understand myself. But yes, I'm a psychic, and I work as a channel to bring messages forward, either from loved ones that have passed or from spirit directly, to help people move forward successfully on their own path, either through healing or sort of taking on projects and steps that they need to find success in themselves.
That's wonderful. And I'm sure that for a lot of our viewers, it's fascinating for a lot of people, the subject and the work that you do. Would you speak a little bit? I know your story is quite interesting. I know a little bit of it. Would you share kind of the highlights of your story and how did you come to do the work that you're doing? Because I know you have other interests and other work that you've done. And by the way, Karissa is a mental projector with a 4-6 profile, which is quite a rare. Mental projectors are quite rare, and they're definitely the future, or the projectors that will lead us into the future. So I know that your talents are, you know, a stand on their own, but your design also is quite fascinating.
Thank you. This started from when I was very young. I've always seen spirits, and I used to see them in the flesh, like sort of in front of me. And this is something that scared me a lot. So there was a lot that I had to move past and get over in terms of my fears. So it took me a very long time. It wasn't until my late 20s that I actually felt comfortable speaking with spirit and translating messages. The path to get here included a lot of therapy work, a lot of body work as well, just to release some old fears and traumas around this part of myself. And, you know, I still work on it every day, but things are getting lighter, clearer, and more open for me, especially the more work that I do on myself.
Wow, that's amazing. So how did you make sort of the transition from kind of, you know, seeing those spirits and being afraid and understanding that this is like a talent or a gift that you have that can help you help others? Was there like a one moment that was kind of an insight, or was there a series of moments? Was there someone who's had an influence on you, like one person or a number of people who have helped you get clear and be able to hear those messages?
Yes. So it was actually one moment. So this was after, you know, a couple of years of therapy and my therapist basically saying, like, you're in control of your own life. Like, you make the decisions, and when you're ready, you open up to this. And I didn't believe it, but I said, you know what, give it a try. I said, if I'm in control, then I can control what spirits come forward and how they show themselves. And as soon as I said that, I did have a spirit come forward. It was a family member. And she came forward, not just in the flesh. She came forward in a different way, more so through like my mind's eye. And she communicated to me, you know, this is what you have to do. We're going to help you. You have a team of people here who are going to help you. So when you're ready, let's get started. This absolutely scared me. So I closed off to it right away. And took me a couple weeks to sort of open that back up, because I thought, by opening it, could never close it again, but that's not true. It's very safe, and spirits are very light and positive. So when I did open it back up, I speak with 4 individuals who are passed, and they said, okay, get a piece of paper and a pen out. We're going to tell you how to do a reading, and we will help you do it. I'm like, okay. So I wrote down the steps, and they said, you have to put yourself out there. Like, just start telling people that this is what you do. I did that even though I didn't believe in myself at the time. And they did in fact help me. I did the readings as they told me to with the steps. I opened things, closed things, asked for certain information. And they really showed up for me and helped me read other people. And as I did start to do that, I realized how helpful it was for others, but also for myself. There's a very strong level of healing for both parties involved, which was really amazing to see.
Wow. And can I ask how long ago was this? And also, how has your work evolved since then?
Yes. Yeah, so this was about 3 years ago when this happened. And the work, my work has evolved in a very large way, I want to say. I went from being very afraid, very nervous, but still trying to show up for myself and others, to now feeling very comfortable. Like, it feels like this is my purpose and this is what my work looks like for the rest of my life. I mean, it is still going to evolve. I've been told this is not where it ends. But at the time, you know, I just had to show up and learn how to decipher messages, because messages are shown in metaphors or symbols, sometimes spoken word or a feeling. And it took me a long time to figure out what every symbol and message meant. But now I sort of have like a legend almost, where if I see something, I'm like, okay, I know it means this. So let's move forward from that.
Yeah. Wow, that's fascinating. And the more you share, the more fascinating it becomes. Would you be able to give us a couple of examples of anything that you're comfortable to share, obviously, because I'm sure some of it is your personal way of, you know, interpreting information, but anything that you're able to share, just to let us into your world a little bit.
Yes. So, for example, I've had a couple of clients where either it's my own guides or their own guides or loved ones that have come forward, and they'll show me a symbol. And what they do is they crush up garlic and then they rub it on their belly. And I've come to learn that that means the person is pregnant. So as soon as I see that, I'm like, okay, you're expecting. And then a lot of the times, like, this has happened more than once, where they'll say like, yes, no one knows. I'm literally like 2 weeks, like we just found out 2 weeks ago. I'm like, okay, so I know that that's what that symbol means.
Wow.
Yeah, so that's one of them. Another piece, that this is something I've experienced for myself in my own life, and this was with my grandmother and one of my dogs. I knew when they were going to transition, because their soul came to me a couple days before and said, okay, my soul is starting to leave. It's going to happen, you know, in 3 days' time or however many days. And then, you know, sadly, fortunately, and unfortunately, it happened as they said. And so, you know, the positive in it is that they showed me, and I kind of knew. But of course, like, always hard when someone does transition out.
Of course, of course. Now, that's just so, I mean, the fact that, you know, they came to you a couple of days before, is there anything that the spirit shared with you in regards to kind of when the soul crosses over, or even like the people that have crossed over? I guess these are the people that you're talking to. Have they shared, like, I think you said there, one of them is family member. I mean, I just have so many questions. I don't even know where to start, but these are obviously spirits that have, like, people who have transitioned over.
Yes.
Is that my understanding? Yeah. Okay. And then have they shared any information around kind of when people transition, what it means or how it happens? Anything that you can share?
Yes. So they've shown me what the soul looks like when it transitions. Now, I believe that all of us see things differently. So everyone has the spirits, energy realms. It's just how much you, it's just if it's something that you want to take on in this lifetime. It's kind of like an artist. Like, everyone can learn to paint, but not everyone's going to be a painter, right? You have to pick up the tools and practice and practice. So it's very similar to that.
Yes.
So the way that they've shown me that they transition is, it almost looks like the soul breaks up into compartments. And when I see that baby wants to come in, so soul wants to come into body, I'll see parts of the soul transitioning in a compartment-like state into the body. And if the soul is completely transitioned, then I'll see, you know, all the compartments have sort of made the complete transition. Now, when I see that someone is not well or about to transition, I can see that parts of the compartments are starting to leave. And they'll show me more or less like, okay, it's going to take about 7 days for the rest of the soul to transition out of the, mm-hmm. of the human body. That's how they've shown it to me. Now to other people, it may look similar and it may look slightly different.
Wow. That's fascinating. Now I know in your work, you also talk a lot about the fact that a lot of people have this ability, or at least have in some way an ability to connect with spirit and to connect to their intuition and kind of get on their path. So can you talk about kind of your thoughts and kind of what you know from spirit around this, and how do you help others who want, because I know that you also teach, or you used to teach even like how people can connect in their own way. So can you talk a little bit about that, please?
Of course. Exactly as you said, like everyone does have this ability to connect, and connecting looks very different for all of us. Some of us perhaps will connect to spirits or to understanding energy on the earthly level and what that feels like. If, you know, you can tune into if someone is sad or happy or depressed, whatever it is. And that might look like colors of energy or waves or anything like that.
Yes.
The most important piece to accessing this part of the self is working on getting rid of the ego completely and working on the confidence piece. So believing that we can do this. So the heaviest thing that we carry is our emotional baggage. Therapy does wonders for that. You need to unpack, unlayer, let that go. And then that allows you to sort of access these other parts of the self, because they exist. Like all realms exist at the same time on top of each other, and they're right in front of us. It's just that we're too distracted by everything that goes on in the 3D.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Work to sort of remove that, then we can access. And with my clients specifically, the way that I can help them do that is I can see where there are energy blockages within the body. And usually stagnation occurs from things that have happened to us when we were younger, or, you know, in our earlier lives that we've never been able to let go of. So perhaps it's a strained relationship with a parent or a sibling or anything like that. Often we don't release it at the time of when it happens. We kind of experience it, we hold it, and then we put it deep into the body somewhere, and it just sits there and it kind of grows. Unfortunately for some people, this can grow into an illness within their body that happens way more often than I'd like to see, but it does. So I'll tune into where these blockages sit, and then spirit helps me give the person a specific instruction on how to remove and release these blocks. And by doing that, then that gets us a little bit closer to accessing psychic information.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's fascinating. So for our readers, I mean, readers of yours, well, maybe some of them are going to be kind of, you know, listening, I guess, and reading whatever they, you know, they, however they interpret it. But is there anything that you find is common, kind of like that can help people connect besides therapy? Are there any things like around kind of walks in nature or anything else that you can recommend that can help?
Self-care practices are huge. So this is, finding a sort of ritual in your daily shower or bath. So cleansing off stagnant energy by using elements. So water, salt scrubs, oils, candles, things like that. This sort of resets the body temporarily. Eating a lot of nourishing foods and almost like intuitively eating. So if you feel like, you know, you feel drawn to warm soups, like make sure that you're following that intuition. And then nature is number one. It like immediately grounds us, removes things that don't serve us. So if you can get out for a 20-minute walk every day, like in the middle of a forest or touching a tree or smelling the tree, anything like this, this sort of helps to heighten and remove a lot of those like outer blockages.
Mm-hmm. That's wonderful. Thank you. Thank you. And in your work also, you know, you can sometimes talk to spirits like of the past, of the loved ones that have passed, with messages and so on. And like in this work, where do you find people kind of like, what are the kind of the most common things that people ask or come to you for?
Mostly for vocation. So reason that they've come to Earth, and how to achieve that, or how to sort of help them on their path in that regard. Everyone you know, everyone has their place on earth. Everyone has a reason as to why you're here at this specific time. Sometimes it coincides with career, sometimes it doesn't. But the most important thing is that people do find it. And I find that most people have the most interest in that area.
That's so fascinating. And you yourself, I know you're a new mom and you've got obviously a lot of things going on. Sometimes people who have your abilities, at least in my experience, are not able to necessarily feel things about themselves. Like sort of, did you know, like how is your, has your path worked? Like, do you go to other psychics if you need support, or do you feel things about yourself? Or do you find because you're emotionally attached to that information, since it's your life, that it's a little harder to get to be clear sometimes?
Yes. So it's very hard for me to read myself because it's hard for me to decipher between like what it is I desire, what I'm going through, my fears. So I often do see a psychic myself. There have been certain moments in my life where I just knew I had to follow certain, let's say, premonitions, or I've been given visions almost like I knew when I would be pregnant. They showed me what the leaves would look like at the time when I would be pregnant. So sometimes I get visions like that. But often when I need an answer to something, I can ask and I'll get an answer, but I'm too biased. So I'm learning how to trust myself on that. So I definitely do see a psychic.
Yeah, that's so interesting. Cause I find in many other areas of our life, we might be so good and have the ability to help, but when it comes to our own work, it's not always like to help ourselves. It's not always as clear, I find.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fascinating. And I know that you and I have worked on your design, and how are you finding sort of being a projector and being a mental projector, which is, you know, quite rare, and your intuition works in a, you know, sort of in a rare way where, you know, you often have to either talk through something or you have to sort of find a way that to figure out. And it sounds like you kind of have this ability to see the visions and to kind of separate where your mind works and where your kind of the spirit and your intuition talks to you. How would you say kind of knowing about your design, but also kind of understanding it has helped you?
So it's helped me in a couple of ways. It's helped me to understand basically like which method I should use with putting myself out there. Because, you know, I've tried many different things. You follow social media. I'm like, oh, like I have to maybe put myself in this way. And it just doesn't resonate, or like it's too hard. It's too much work. So when I did do the session with you and you touched on a huge part of that, of how I should be basically putting myself out there. And one of the ways is to sort of just, you know, let people know what I do and then slowly try to attract things in as opposed to constant social media, this, that. I found that that has helped immensely. Like I feel that I have a lot more success with it by just being authentic, only sharing when I need to, as opposed to trying to follow this social media trend, which has burned me out. So knowing where my skills lie has been incredibly helpful.
Oh, that's so wonderful. Thank you for sharing that. Yeah, because I do feel like you have such an amazing skill or talent and a gift. At the same time, I think spending a lot of time kind of on social media is probably not a thing for a projector to do necessarily. It's about using your energy in the right way and having the right people come to you. And as a 4-6, you know, it is about networking and connecting to the people that you know, and kind of getting them to refer business to you as well. Because through knowing you and understanding how you work, they can give you a good reference, but also explain to others what worked for them.
Yes, that's been huge. Yeah.
Yeah. And so what are you working on now? Because I know you were doing a few things at the time, and I know now you're stepping sort of into this new chapter of being a new mom and trying to juggle kind of your own business and obviously raising a beautiful little baby. So please share what you do now and how you work so that whoever is interested can reach out and and work with you.
It's certainly a transitionary time, a wonderful one. I think any time of transition is beautiful. You always find yourself in a different light at the end of it, or at some point in the phase.
Yes.
In terms of my work, so I'm working out of a space now, so I get to see people in person, which is wonderful. I offer psychic readings, and then I also offer intuitive development sessions where I help people either read their own aura, communicate with spirits, see into their past lives, or meet their teams and guides. The way that it works is I'll sort of open things up and I can see what you're seeing, and we'll work together to go into it. It's almost like a guided way to meet the individuals that are showing up for you. So I offer that. And I also offer with a colleague of mine a couple of workshops. So card reading classes and past life group sessions. So I'm excited about all of this. And I think it not only will be helpful for me in terms of my own healing journey, but I think it's helpful for others too.
Of course. And I love that you're offering those intuition development and psychic development sessions, because I think people who might be inclined to think that they have those abilities, we always need the guidance, right? We always need sometimes, especially if somebody is just getting on this path and might be very interested, they need some guidance and they need somebody to hold their hand or explain to them what's happening, just like it happened with you a few years ago.
Yeah.
And having the ability to get out of our own way, I think, is so important.
It's funny that you say that, because at the time, you know, at the time I didn't see it, but the four people that I do speak to that are past, they always say, like, you know, we're your teachers. We're the ones that have helped you. At the time, I did feel very alone. And I always thought, oh, like, I wish someone was here to help me. And that's always been one of my goals. I want to be able to help people who are also in that situation. You know, it's not an uncommon thing that people see spirits in their room and then maybe close off to it because they're like, what is this? Or they want to know more and connect. And I feel so lucky that I get to help be a guide to that in some way.
Yes, of course. And can you talk a little bit about, because I know that during COVID, you've done a lot of online work. And from my understanding, you know, there's no real difference. I mean, it is nice to work with someone in person, but at the same time, geography should not be the limiting factor. We know that energy is kind of there. So can you talk a little bit, just to give our viewers like an understanding whether there's a difference or not in you seeing somebody in person and whether you still do online sessions?
Yes. So yes, during the 2 years that we were all kind of home, I was doing everything virtually. And for me, there is no difference. I actually almost prefer just over the phone because I feel less distracted. Yeah, no matter what, whoever is there, whatever they want to share, they do share. I act as a channel and it can be done anywhere. I actually recently had an experience where someone wanted me to communicate with a spirit that sort of resides in their house. And I did it from my house. We just did it through messages, and a lot of the information that came up was spot on. So they were very happy with my services at the time. But it's something that I can do from anywhere, which is nice. So I still am offering virtual.
That's wonderful. And just because I have you here, and it's like when you work with people, and I know that you see aura, and like sometimes, you know, you kind of, well, not sometimes, but you need to focus and sort of, do you see, as you know, we all have sometimes people behind us or the loved ones. Do you see that with everybody, like what's happening, like how they have maybe their angels or you know, their loved ones behind them? How do you see that, and is there like a common theme, or like does everybody usually have like a guide on each side, or how do you see that? I was just curious, and I'm sure our viewers would love to hear a little bit about that.
Yes, everyone has specific spirits or guides that do come around them. Sometimes it's angels and sometimes it's galactic beings. And these are, you know, that's a whole other part to this, but I believe that from what they've shown me on Earth, a lot of us come from galactic being DNA. So sometimes they do want to make their way forward to share some information. I've asked that I don't see people in the flesh anymore. So now they kind of show me through my mind's eye. Sometimes I'll ask to see around the person, which I'm okay with that too. And they kind of just show up either behind or beside, and they show what their role is for the person. So yes, everyone has guides and teams. Some people have angels that come around where it's consistent, and some just have them come around sometimes. And then the galactic being part, it's sometimes as well. So it depends on what the person's role is in this lifetime and if they need to make contact or connect with these individuals.
Wow, that's just so fascinating. Mm-hmm. And do you, like, now more and more I find, and kind of the people that I know, a lot of them have talked about, like, maybe using meditation to even sort of connect to their own intuition, to hear themselves and to be able to quiet that noise or to kind of not have that ego stand in the way. How do you feel about meditation? And do you find that's important in this work? Can you speak a little bit about that?
I think meditation is wonderful. The more time you can spend meditating, the better. It really does allow us to sort of drop parts of the earthly self and go to another space dimensionally. Like astral traveling is really interesting and very important. And if you can go there, that's wonderful, because there's so much information that we can gather from those spaces.
Yes.
And then when it comes to meditating, you know, you can meditate in so many different ways. You can do a walking meditation in the forest. You can lay down on the couch and close your eyes as if you're about to take a nap, but you're still conscious. It doesn't necessarily have to be, you know, sitting in a somewhat kind of uncomfortable position where you're upright. Yeah. You can sit wherever and do it wherever. But there's a lot of information that sits just above the layer of meditating. And if you're open to it, you can ask for it to come forward.
Yeah, that's wonderful. And what are your ways to protect your energy? Because as we know, you know, there's different energies out there. And when you go and sort of and channel, do you worry about kind of protecting yourself, or do you follow a certain ritual? Can you share a little bit about that? And how would you recommend others who are potentially looking to maybe, start this work, or, you know, have just kind of, you know, are interested? Can you shed some light on that?
Yes. So intention setting is really important. And you can intention set in many different ways. You can verbally say it, you can write it on a piece of paper, and it's has everything to do with your boundaries. So if you want, you know, your house to be a safe space, you can write on a piece of paper. I invite only, you know, lovely and positive spirits and angels, and they can only come forward when I ask. So as long as you're making this known in the world, then it's very powerful. You can use crystals as well. I find that crystals are used more as a symbol. So yes, crystals have properties, but it's more so this symbol that it represents. So you can place them in your home and say, like, okay, I'm putting this here, and this is a protective barrier for me and my loved ones, that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Opening and closing things, I do think it's important to safely open it just by asking, you know, okay, I'm comfortable with these people to come forward. And once it's done, thank you for coming forward. I'm going to close this now. When I invite you back, you can come forward again. The thing with spirits is that they'll kind of go on and on. Like, they do want to talk to you, and they don't really have limits or barriers or boundaries. So we need to set. In terms of being afraid of anything, there is nothing to be afraid of. We're in human bodies, so we have power or strength, let's say. So we really are the ones to set those boundaries. Yeah, if that makes sense.
Yeah, absolutely. So if I understood you correctly, so it's a combination. So one is setting intention, and I find it's important for a lot of things that we do in life, just in general, to get used to setting intention for the things that we start, or for even small things. And then the second one, I guess, is creating boundaries and opening and closing the space. So I guess understanding that there's kind of a finality, and maybe, because I guess sometimes in life we sort of maybe start something, but we don't necessarily close off. because I could sort of relate to that. And then the third one, I guess, is creating boundaries, right? And being kind of very specific about how much, you know, what we want, and maybe even inviting sometimes, like you said, the crystals or something that can help us feel that we're protected.
Yeah. And everyone can use whichever method works for them. You may even say, like, okay, when I light this candle, I'm opening it. When I close it, it's closed. Like, if you want to use a tool, you can. You don't have to. You can do this all in your mind and say it in your mind's eye. It just depends on the person, what they feel most comfortable with, or what they feel works the most powerfully, let's say.
Yeah, absolutely. And how do you help your clients sort of through the time of uncertainty? Because I know, during COVID, like there was quite a few people who were, I'm sure, you know, and like you said, people come to you in regards to vocation. What would be the second, I guess, kind of most important question asked that you find people come to you for? And what are some fears that people bring to you?
A lot of people come for career. So work and family as well. And so often spirit gives me timelines. Now these are projected timelines and, you know, all of us have free will. So we can make whatever decision that we want,
yes.
But these are favorable timelines. So it's like, okay, there's a couple steps to follow and you've got like, it's very favorable for you. So you've been 6 months and this is what it will bring. And that's sort of, I think that's how spirit sort of brings comfort to us, because it gives us a plan of action. Now, if someone doesn't follow it within 6 months, the opportunity is still there for them. It's just that it'll be a new timeline and maybe it's a bit more challenging. Maybe there's a few more roadblocks because they wanted us to follow, spirit wanted us to follow it the initial time.
Yes.
But yeah, more mostly around the second would be career, family, and how to navigate certain things when there are transitions happening.
Okay, very interesting. And I guess before we close off, is there anything that you want to share or kind of any of kind of your advice or insights that you can leave us with as far as, you know, there's a lot of uncertainty going on in the world and, you know, different predictions and we're going, you know, in the Northern Hemisphere, we're going into sort of into winter, which is more of a quieter time of hibernating for nature, for animals, and I find that people usually tend to feel a little bit down as well. So what are some of your ways that you cope with that and you find that sort of joy and inspiration in your life?
So yes, there are definitely a lot of messages for the collective and for everyone. One of the biggest things is to, and this is a message I've been told for a long time now, we need to get back to our roots, go back to what's natural, and find joy in those little, and they're not really little, in those like grand daily tasks. So they want you to sort of, they want everyone to become self-sustainable when it comes to nourishing themselves. So perhaps that's an indoor garden, you know, for in the winter, or you drink your teas to nourish the body through herbs. So growing your herbs, and doing all of this with intention. So waking up and knowing that you have purpose to, you know, feed yourself and the loved ones around you, because we are going into a very interesting age and time where self-sustainability will be very important. So the sooner you start to build your homes around being self-sustainable, the better it's going to be for you, family, for your energy flow, essentially.
Wow, that's great. Yeah, and I totally agree with that message. I think it's so important. And not to rely on others, right? To be kind of self-sufficient, self-sustainable, and have sort of that, and also trust our intuition as well.
Yes. And that's good. Because the more energy and intention we put into every small detail that we do for ourselves, again, just down to drinking a cup of tea, if you make it with love and you take the time, that tea is going to be so nourishing for you, as opposed to going through a drive-through picking up a tea. There's a lot of differences in the energy in those two teas that you drink for yourself. And that's just a small scale thing. This translates to everything else.
Yeah, that's a great point. Mm-hmm. The amount, what we put into something, right? Like if we do something with the intention of love and prepare it for ourselves versus just picking something up at Tim Hortons or Starbucks.
Yeah.
Now, how can we, so for example, if somebody is on a run and like they have a really busy lifestyle, how can they be able to, like if they're not able to make that tea, is there anything that they can do when they pick up that tea from Starbucks? Can they put the intention into it when they're drinking it in that moment when somebody else prepared it, but they are still kind of the person drinking it?
Yeah. And I'm guilty to this as well. I wish I had all the time in the world to sit and do these things. It's more so just sort of setting yourself up so that majority of the time you can do these things, you know, here and there, it's okay. You know, we're going to restaurants, things like this, that's fine, because there is something with someone else preparing something for you. Yeah. But terms of going forward into new age, it's more so setting up your home so that you have access to these things on a more regular basis.
Mm-hmm. So having kind of, a, like you said, our own garden or our own ways to grow sustainable products and things like that.
Yeah. And maybe, you know, even the night before you make a steeped tea in the fridge and, you know, maybe either you heat it up or you drink it cold the next day. Just think having things like accessible to you on hand.
That's a good point. Wow. So much knowledge, Karissa. Thank you so much. So appreciate it. Do you want to share how people can find you? And obviously I will share like a lot of all of your links on the bottom, but do you want to, you know, maybe share the best ways that people can find you online and also kind of find a way to book a session with you?
Yeah, so I have Instagram where I post a couple of things. My handle's at Karissa Pezzillo, and you can check me out there. There's a bit of information, and then my website as well, which is www.karissapezzillo.com, and you can book sessions through there.
And how far in advance? Because I know that for a while you were so, so busy that, you know, there was like nothing available for a couple of months.
Yes.
Is this still kind of happening, or is people able to kind of to get to you a little bit sooner?
So yes, I do have availability sooner. I've got some openings this December, and then I will end of January and February going forward.
Okay, that's great. Well, thank you so much for your time. This has been wonderful.
Thank you for having me. It's so nice.
Of course. I'm so glad. And I'm so glad that you're doing so well and able to manage your, you know, your hectic life and doing what you love. Because in the end of the day, you know, and doing what you love with courage, because this is not kind of your, you know, mainstream, you know, necessarily mainstream work, meaning like it's not something that people traditionally considered, you know, the work that, you know, one would do as and kind of share. So, you know, with others. And I just feel that, you know, your gift and your talents are so needed in the world, especially now, and your ability to talk about things in such an authentic way and so clearly share those messages is so important, and to actually give people confidence in their own abilities. So thank you for that.
You're very similar. So I'm also grateful to the work that you do. Thank you for sharing everything.
Of course. Well, it's been wonderful to showcase your amazing talents, and I'm hoping that our viewers can reach out and learn from your story and how you're stepping out into the world and daring to be who you are. Thank you for your time. Thank you for today. Take care. We'll talk soon. Thank you.